Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir with another Shopify how-to video. And in this video, I'll teach you guys how you can add dark and light mode to your Shopify Dawn theme 7.0.0. So user will be able to switch from dark to light mode. You will have a floating button like this. And when someone click on that, they'll be able to switch from light to dark mode. So that's the default color scheme, which is light mode. And when someone click on it, it will show us the dark mode with the darker backgrounds and white font color. Now let's take a look at the inner page of how it looks in the dark mode. Let's go to our collection page. That's how the collection page will look like. Was it our product page? That's how our product page will look like. And now last but not least, the cart page. And that's how our cart page will look like. So if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe the channel. Also, let me know in the comments below if you want me to create this tutorial for you for any other theme like debut theme or any other theme which you're using. So without further ado, let's get into the tutorial. So guys, I'm on the back end of my Shopify store. Current theme is activated is Dawn 7.0.0, and I have already added all of the codes for dark and light mode, which is activated. Now I have also installed the latest and fresh version of Dawn 7.0, where I haven't touched any of the files or the code. So we'll first publish this theme. Let's publish this one and start adding the code so I can teach you guys how you can add the dark and light mode functionality to your Dawn theme. Okay, now our theme is published. Now let's go to the store and here we are. So that's the default color scheme and that's how the default Dawn 7.0.0 looks like. Now we will edit our code, and before editing the code, make sure to duplicate your theme, because if you add up any wrong code, it will be a complete mess. So make sure to have a backup before doing so. Okay, now click on actions, then edit code. Now our first step is to add the jQuery to our theme. So I'll go to my theme.liquid file, and in there I'll add jQuery. So let's search for jQuery CDN. That's the first language I'll go to. And here we have jQuery 3.6.1 latest version. Click on minify it and then copy this script tag. After copying this, paste it to your theme.liquid under head. Okay, now click save. Okay, now our next step is to find for the file called announcement-bar.liquid. And in this file on line number 10, after this div, I'll add my button. So here's the code for the button. Don't worry about the codes. I'll put the link of a blog post in YouTube video description where you will find all of the codes. You will just need to copy and paste the codes. So in announcement bar, line number 10, I'll add this code. And then the next step is to go to your header.liquid file. I'll search for header.liquid file. And in here, I'll go to line number 377. Sorry, it's not the line number 377, it's actually line number 381. To make sure you're adding the code on the correct line, you will need to search for this class, header underscore heading dash logo. So wherever you see that class, you will need to add another class after adding a space, and that's the class which you will be adding. Okay, after adding this class, hit save. After saving this file, we will add another code in same header.liquid file, which is this. So in this code, we are adding dark mode logo. So you might have two different logos for the lighter version and the darker version. I'm currently adding this code for the darker version logo. And make sure to change this URL with your darker version logo. So I have already uploaded my darker version to Shopify files. So if I go to Shopify admin, click on settings and then go to files. Here you can see I have two different versions of logo. So this one, what I'm gonna do, I'll update it from customize, and this one I'll add it on code manually. So make sure to upload your darker version logo and copy the link for this image and paste it on this code in SRC. After doing it, I'll copy the full code and add it below these two double braces. So before else, it's line number 387, but make sure to add it after this code. So you'll first see section settings logo. Wherever this code is ending with double braces, you'll need to add this code here. Now click on save. Our announcement bar file is also not saved, so I'm going to save that one too. And now let's go to next step, which is adding the JS code to your global.js file. Now search for global.js. And in global.js, scroll down to the bottom and add this JS code. So the code which I have created is specifically for Dawn 7.0.0 and Dawn 6.0.0.0.2. It might not work on any other theme. If you're having issues implementing this code to any other theme, give me a shout out on comment and I'll help you guys. I'll try my best to help you guys with the code. Okay, after adding the JS code in global.js file, the last step is to add the CSS code. Now copy this and search for CSS and then add your code to base.css file. In base.css file, scroll down to the bottom and add this code to the bottom of your theme. Hit save. And now I'll go to my store and hit refresh to make sure we have our button showing up with the dark and light mode functionality. Okay guys, our code is working fine. If I click on light mode, it's switching to light mode. Clicking on dark mode makes it switch to dark mode. Now let's try out the inner pages of how it looks. Okay, that's how the inner pages looks like. Let's take a look at the product page. Cool, the product page looks fine too. Now the only thing remaining is the logo. As you can see, I haven't yet added the logo, that's why it's not changing. So what I'm gonna do, I'll go to my online store and then click on customize. Click on customize. And from there, I'll add my logo. Click on header. And then from default logo, click on change, select image, and then I'll select the logo, which is for the default version. Don't select the darker version logo because we added it via code. Selected the default version of your logo. Now click select and then save. Now let's go back to our Shopify store and hit refresh. And here we go. As you can see, we are seeing our logo, which is for the dark mode. Now, if I click on the light mode, it will show the light mode logo. And if I click on dark mode, it will show the dark mode logo. Okay, guys, that's it for the tutorial. I hope you guys liked it. This tutorial took me about 4 to 5 hours of code, the JS code, the JavaScript code, the CSS and HTML code. So please support me by subscribing the channel and commenting, liking on the video. So until next video, have a great day.